Change the world as fast and as well as possible. How to change the world as fast and as well as possible. Every crime is a political crime. Of course I'm a utopian. Where else could I be? I was brought up in the Broadway Central Hotel. My demand is total bliss for everyone forever. My demand is total bliss for everyone forever. Now you can say, yeah, but what if I don't want total bliss? It's not the point. This is Thelma Gadson, and I got 304 more days in this here house a day.
Up with the body and the mind.
And down with the state.
And down with the state.
So I got into Piscata's school, and I was in Handel's Way to Heaven, a famous German play. And they said rehearsals would be Friday night and Saturday morning. And I said, wait a minute. And I realized then and there, in some immediate way, I was either going to give up the idea of theater, which has a Friday night and Saturday night audience that we don't know how to ignore, or I was not going to keep the Shabbos in that sense. So I made a little drawing of a little synagogue with some guys standing around with payas and big hats, looking up at me, at that time skinny girl, with a big picket sign. And the rabbonim were going, ah! And the picket sign said, when my work is prayer and praise, I will labor 7 days. All my life, I believed that I was a German Jew. And we had come here, and in fact, we have come here when I was about 2 years old. 1928, I came here. I was brought as an infant. And my father founded, he was a rabbi, founded the German Jewish congregation here. Put in our newspaper called the Jüdische Zeitgeist, and created a small German Jewish community of which I was a part. The German Jews absurdly have some idea that they're superior to Polish Jews and treat them miserably. And in fact, my father in his newspaper put out editorials that said, we educated German Jews must have compassion on our Polish fellow Jews. Even if they're dirty and uneducated and stink, we have to understand that they're the victim of the same oppression that we are. And we must help them in their troubles. I was brought up that way, and then eventually, when my second parent died, I had a struggle, family papers, the way one inherits. And there I find out that I was in fact a Polish Jew, that both my parents were Polish, and both lied about it. And both were part of the terrible discriminatory process that's gone on for years and still goes on between Polish Jews and German Jews. I was a teenager. I lived on the Upper West Side. I met Julian Beck, who lived in this apartment. I was 18 years old. And then a couple of years after that, Julian and I got married, and we moved into the building across the street, 789 West End Avenue. This is 800 West End Avenue. And Julian had a mother who looked out of the window and took care of me all the time and said, "Judith, I just happened to be looking out the window and I saw you bring your baby home. Judith, this is January. He wasn't wearing a hat. Are you trying to kill that child? Or worse yet, talking of bohemia." She would say, "Judith, good morning. I wasn't sleeping so well last night. And at around 4 o'clock, I looked out of the window and I saw four drunken men coming out of 789 West End Avenue. And I know they were coming from your apartment. And what I want to know is, what do you do up there all night?"